Let's go to the Corona tail of the tape. Sponsored by Corona, who invites you to find your beach. Sammy Vasquez versus Felix Diaz. Not young guys, again, kind of on the way up. You see the records 21-0 for Vasquez, 17-1 for Diaz. But Vasquez is 30, Diaz 32, former Olympic gold medalist. Let's go to the ring and our ring announcer, Ray Flores. You see, Vasquez is the taller man in the ring, and we're going by the unified rules of boxing. No standing eight, no three knockdown rule. Only the ref can stop the fight. You cannot be saved by the bell in any round. And if we go after four rounds because of some sort of cut or something else, it can be go to the partial round scored after four rounds for a technical decision. Before that, it will be ruled a no decision. We're underway. Sammy Vasquez versus Felix Diaz. Brian Kenny here with Virgil Hunter and Danny Garcia. Danny, we didn't get you to weigh in on this fight. What do you think of the matchup?
I think it's an even matchup. I think it's a 50-50 even matchup. You know, two southpaws, you know, both not tremendous big punches, but good technicians, and I think it's a great even matchup.
Good body shot by Vasquez early.
Vasquez doing what he said he was going to do. He was going to keep his range and pick and poke to the body and eventually bring it back upstairs. Right away, he's trying to establish that.
Has Diaz back up on the ropes already. Diaz, former Olympic champion, comes off a disputed loss to Lamont Peterson. Danny, you know a little bit about the class of Lamont Peterson. Pretty good fighter, so that shows you the level we're talking about.
Yeah, Lamont's a tremendous fighter. Diaz brought it that night. He has to bring that same mentality tonight. I didn't think he would come out being a less aggressive fighter, but I guess he has a game plan and he's sticking to it.
What do you think of that, Virgil? I mean, just kind of backing up and staying there. What do you think?
Well, right along the ropes a minute ago, Diaz made a little move to his right. So he's going to try to create an angle on Vasquez's aggressiveness. He's trying to anticipate Vasquez stepping in. He's taking his time and trying to figure out what Vasquez wants to do before he starts reacting to it. That's what he wants to do. He's trying to step over with his rear leg and create that angle and throw to the left and come back with the hook.
And Danny, you can imagine, again, this was supposed to be Luis Collazo against Vasquez, so you know you've got to match him up, say, hey, we still want to keep this date. We want to keep you active. What do you think of Felix Diaz? You must think, hey, wait a second. this guy might be even better than Luis Collazo.
Yeah, that's a quality fighter, Olympic gold medalist. That was my Olympic year. You know, I didn't make it to the Olympics, but he won the gold medal, first Dominican ever to win a gold medal. So this guy's not a pushover. He's coming here to win.
Yeah, he came back to the Dominican Republic as a conquering hero. They had a big parade for him.
I noticed he's trying to land that left hand, that overhand left. He's waiting for Vasquez to throw, then he throws the overhand left.
Indeed,
he
did
it a couple
of
times this round.
He just missed one. Vasquez is keeping his right hand real low. Whether he's trying to bait him into it or not and counter, we don't know, but Diaz definitely sees it.
Final 30 seconds. What do you think of the work rate, quickly, Virgil? I'm surprised by Vasquez again. The work rate is slowed down a bit here in the first round.
Well, it has to. He's fighting somebody who's not a pushover. You're talking about an Olympic gold medalist with a high pedigree, and you have to take your time. You just can't go in reckless. So it's a fill-out round. I wouldn't be surprised if the second round sort of simulates this one.
We're through one. Felix Diaz kind of taking the air out of the ball in round one. Vasquez usually a prolific work rate, slowed down there in the first round. Underway here in round two, the PBC on Fox here at the Legacy Arena. Birmingham, Alabama, Brian Kenny, Virgil Hunter, and welterweight titleist Danny Garcia, the former junior welterweight champion of the world. And Vasquez was throwing your name around yesterday, Danny, as someone that he would like to shoot up at, of course. Of course, you have, like, there's living legends around who are throwing your name around.
Yeah, I mean, there's a list of fighters you got to get through before you get to me. But, you know, if you want some of, you know, Danny Swift Garcia, I'm here, man.
Just mentioning that your name has popped up as Bob Arum is looking for an opponent for Manny Pacquiao. It'd be interesting.
Man, it would be a great fight, you know, puncher versus puncher. Two fighters who like to fight and get it in. And, you know who he has to call for to make that fight happen. We can definitely right, make that fight happen. Right.
You're not easy. You're not hard to find. You're out there.
Exactly.
One thing Vasquez is doing well, he's dropping down to the height of Diaz, so it makes it a little more difficult for Diaz to bring something over the top. But as I said, the last round is still more of a fill-out round because you have two quick fighters here, and Vasquez has speed, but so does Diaz, so he's probably in here with the quickest fighters he's fought so far in his career.
Vasquez, again, 30 years old, only 19-0, 13 KOs, but again, two tours in Iraq with the National Guard in 2005 and 2008, so that took a good bit of his time. He was in actual combat. He was a senior scout gunner on a striker vehicle, which is kind of being on point. You know, you're the eyes and ears for your vehicle, and you can only imagine the terror that you go through there in combat. Diaz slipping there. Boxing, he says, helps him deal with post-traumatic stress disorder. He wants to help fellow veterans suffering by encouraging them to seek help. He gets therapy once a week. So he is out there for his fellow veterans. And he's out here again. Denny, difficult. Again, you were brought up as a prize fighter. You know, your father was there every step of the way. This guy, you know, went into the National Guard, went to battle, came back, and he's still making a professional career. Very difficult.
Man, it's nothing but respect, man. Takes a lot of heart to go out there, you know, and fight for our country. Ooh. He got hurt right there by a little jab. But, yeah, man, he's a good guy.
Diaz snapped out that jab. You're right, Danny, and then stunned Vasquez for a second.
Diaz is starting to find his range. He started out by poking his jab out. Now he's starting to touch Vasquez with it. So he's finding his range. He's getting closer and closer. So now we see Vasquez on the back foot. I expect this type of fight. Ebbs and flows and back and forwards.
Yeah, that is an interesting point, Virgil, in that we saw early it almost Diaz passive backing up. Now he's the one moving forward and landing a bit as well.
Diaz seems like he has a little bit of a stronger punch than Vasquez.
I agree with you, Dan.
Starting to heat up. We're through two rounds here in Birmingham. Sammy Vasquez trying to stay undefeated against Felix Diaz.
Welcome back to Birmingham. I'm Christine Leahy. I talked to Felix Diaz yesterday about some of his background and growing up. He is from the Dominican Republic, still lives in the same town that he grew up in, and he said that his friends and family still treat him the same. But after he won gold in 2008, he bought the house that he grew up in. He said that the town threw him a parade, and most of all, he's just so proud to come from a place with such limited resources and work hard to be where he is now. Brian.
Christine, thank you. Yeah, again, he came back as a conquering hero, and he is now a captain in the Air Force Reserve in the Dominican Republic in charge of the sports division of the military. Big fan of a lot of baseball players out there as well. Obviously, the Dominican Republic, a hotbed of baseball. Round three, Sammy Vasquez versus Felix Diaz.
Brian, one thing that you alluded to was Vasquez's activity rate. Now, his last fight, he knocked out Aaron Martinez, so sometimes that can convince a fighter that he's a puncher, and he'll be looking for a knockout in this fight. In the fighters' meeting, he said he was looking for a knockout. So is he himself or who he is, or does he think he's turned into a puncher all of a sudden?
What do you think so far?
It's a back-and-forth fight. I give Vasquez the slight edge. Diaz closing the distance. It's becoming more and more interesting. It's anybody's fight now. It's up for grabs.
No, you're right. In that Martinez fight, like, it was Vasquez coming forward constantly, touching him, and dictating, even if he didn't look dominant, because the fight was less than thrilling. But he was still dictating and eventually broke his man down mentally.
Exactly. But again, can he do that with Diaz, who's got the quickness, who's got the intelligence, the ring pedigree, and seems to know what he wants to do? It's a matter of can he get it going more frequently here.
Yeah, Diaz looking for a counter right, now finds the body.
That was a very interesting punch to the liver by Diaz. He went around Vasquez's elbow, so he seems to know where that target is.
Diaz now lunging in at times, a little clumsy, but he's getting inside. And you're right, he threw that left hook with a little bit of conviction. You just touch a guy in there, you can hurt him.
And Vasquez is standing straight up. Diaz is getting Vasquez in a war now, which would give Diaz the advantage.
I noticed that Diaz is reacting better to Vasquez punches than Vasquez punches reacting to Diaz punches.
It's a good point. He's getting in the pocket, too. Diaz is starting to snap off that jab initially coming in. And Virgil, you touched on it. I mean, obviously, with an Olympic gold medal, the amateur pedigree is there. But when you have so many amateur fights, you're just calm walking into every situation. You can see how calm he was at the start, even in a fight that means not everything in his career, but just about. Again, you come off a loss, fine. Lamont Peterson, it was close, but you lose again. You're falling out of the winner's bracket, Dan.
Yeah, he has to He has to have the winner's mentality tonight. He has to be hungry. Like he just did right there, take it to him. Then I'm overhand lefts and right hooks. He has to be the hungry fighter. He has to want this fight.
Diaz wants it here. He's keeping that arm loose, and Keith Hughes is letting him fight. So that was just pushed down there. Hughes doing a good job in letting the fighters fight because Diaz had that arm loose. You don't have to break them up, but now Diaz on the attack.
Vasquez.
Good close to the end of that round. Diaz brings it to Vasquez. We're back after this. Sammy Vasquez there in his corner. And a very different round there. Diaz started to pick it up. And I just, you know what, I like his mentality. He had one arm trapped. He kept the other arm loose and just kept flailing and scoring. Those are scoring shots, Danny.
Yeah, it seemed like it dazed Vasquez a little bit too. You know, he wrapped up with him and he kind of went down to the canvas a little bit. He might have been a little dazed by that rally by Diaz.
Round four, scheduled for 10. Sammy Vasquez undefeated. Felix Diaz off one loss and a close loss to Lamont Peterson. So good welterweight matchup here. Two guys on the way up.
One thing we have to take into account, Brian, that Diaz is with Joel Diaz now, who's a no-nonsense coach who has the great ability to teach an in-fighting game in an aggressive type of style. And Diaz is showing that he's picking up what Joel is teaching him.
And as you say that, Virgil, he just ripped a left right across the body of Vasquez. That was a nice shot.
Left uppercut right inside.
And he has Vasquez leery right now.
You know, I say these guys on the way up, but it is a crowded welterweight division, probably the best in all of the sport. We saw Keith Thurman and Sean Porter in a classic. Kell Brook is moving up to fight Gennady Golovkin, of all people. You've got Pacquiao. You've still got Tim Bradley out there. Amir Khan, your guy, Virgil. Good shot there as they both go to the body. And, of course, Danny Garcia, you're an undefeated world champion in this division as well. I mean, there's so much talent, which is, I guess, good. There's a lot of big money fights out there.
Exactly. You know, all styles match up. There's a lot of great styles, a lot of different personalities. And, you know, all those fights will happen sooner than later.
That's why I'm encouraged when I hear even Bob Arum and Manny Pacquiao mentioning your name so you can cross party lines.
Yeah, that's great, right? For boxing. That's great for boxing. You know, boxing as a whole, you know, not different divisions and different promoters not working with each other, so I think it's great.
Hey, look, you see how good it is when the top guys fight each other. Thurman, Porter, we've been waiting for years, and it was outstanding.
They brought out their best in each other.
Yep. Final minute here in round four, and the action picking up. Diaz finding his rhythm. At some point, Virgil, I'm going to have to ask you how you're scoring this, because it is difficult.
It's very difficult. If I was a judge, and based on what I'm seeing in body language and activity, I would have Diaz slightly ahead, but who knows? I think one thing we talked about earlier, Brian, is that we did see Vasquez this morning at breakfast. And some fighters' opinion and coaches' opinion, we've been giving up a lot of energy by playing some table games and things of that nature, and maybe it could have an effect on him. His punches seem to be getting flatter.
He challenged Danny Garcia, not to a fight, but to horseshoes.
Yeah, I said, I only play games I know how to win. He's getting hit right here. He's getting, you know, beat up a little bit.
Good
right
uppercut
there
by Diaz.
He's taking some big shots here.
Vasquez smiles at him, but basically acknowledging that was a good shot. Diaz hitting him with hard shots, power shots, starting to take control. Could be winning rounds as well. Exciting fight so far here by competitive welterweights. We're back live in Birmingham in a moment. Virgil, if you're on the other side with Vasquez there, as one, the other guy starts to get the better of it and take control of the fight. You see the Sammy Vasquez's family there and his wife as well. What do you tell Sammy Vasquez in the corner?
Well, right now you have to get him back into the fight and get him back in control of the fight, and you take him to what he does best, box. And that's what he seems to start to do when he comes out for this round. He wants to keep his distance, but Diaz is timed him. He's timing Vasquez when he reaches for him, and Diaz is waiting on that and following it back, like there. Vasquez starting to show the wear and tear of the punches around the forehead and around the bridge of the eyes.
He's been getting hit with a lot of clean punches in the last couple of rounds, especially in the clinches and those overhand lefts and right hooks.
If you look at the body language of the two fighters, Diaz is very confident at this moment. Vasquez is trying to figure out what's going on right here. This wasn't supposed to be happening, but it is.
Marcos Villegas has our unofficial scorecard, and I mentioned to you, Virgil, a moment ago, I'm interested in how you'd be scoring these rounds. Now, maybe the last round perhaps was, you know, moving up toward Diaz, but you see, Marcos had Vasquez winning the first three rounds. And it comes down to, and look, this is very controversial. You can get into the scoring. A lot of times, neither guy is really winning the round, and you can have one fighter winning close round after round after round. Doesn't mean he's blowing them out, but it means he's winning the close rounds, and Marcos believes that Vasquez is on top. I mean, look, that's the way you score the fight.
I think the difference is Diaz is hurting Vasquez with these punches.
Mm-hmm.
And Vasquez is doing some good work, but he's not hurting him. He's looked like he's getting backed up. He's a little weak. He's doing a good job at boxing, but Diaz is landing the better, clean, effective punches.
And Diaz is also imposing his will. He is moving forward no matter what on Vasquez here as he tries to fire off some power shots.
Vasquez can't lay on the ropes and let this guy beat him up, take energy away. He has to circle out of there. His fight's in the middle of the ring, center of the ring, using that jab.
I have to say, I like the job Keith Hughes is doing, too. He only gets involved when he has to.
Yeah, he's letting Diaz fight his fight.
Winging shots coming out from Diaz.
Well, Vasquez is facing speed for the first time in his pro career, and he's not sure what to do with it. And so he's uncertain right now. He felt that he was going to come out here and just one way dictate this fight, and it's not going his way right now. Diaz very comfortable, landed the big shots. It's slowly going Diaz's way. There's the body language I'm talking about. He makes Diaz look great in this situation.
He's roughing him up right now.
Uppercut and hook combination nicely done by Felix Diaz.
And watch Diaz as he uses his legs and shifts different positions. And Vasquez is keeping his feet in a standstill position, so Diaz is able to work him everywhere. Big shot landed there. He's hurt.
Overhand lefts landed by Felix Diaz. As we end the round, Diaz coming on strong. Back here live in Birmingham, Alabama, the PBC on Fox. You see both fighters in this good welterweight scrap. Felix Diaz coming on strong. But again, it's not at the end. I've told this to fans going back decades now. It's not who you think won at the end. It's the scorecard you turn in round after round after round. Marcos Villegas just put out his unofficial scorecard. You could still have Vasquez ahead, even if you think Diaz is getting the better of it. And I think we're starting to think that, especially in these last two rounds. Likely winning these last two. Now round six, scheduled for 10.
This is a very pivotal round. If Vasquez doesn't take back control of this fight, he's going to really dig a big hole for himself.
Well, Virgil, what do you think he should be doing? I mean, like, technically, doubling up on a jab, moving forward, circling a certain way. What physically should he be doing? Whoa.
Stepped on his shoe right there. Yeah, stepped on his shoe.
Well, as I said earlier, he had stopped his previous opponent, Aaron Martinez, in the last fight. And sometimes you can con yourself into thinking that you're a puncher. So he's not doing what he does best. What he does best is box in and out, put combinations together. His work rate is high and basically overwhelms the opponent, like in that situation right there.
Tell you what, those are scoring shots right there. So again, as we're talking, scoring shots are happening from Vasquez. So now the work rate takes over. He's got Diaz backing up.
Now there's Diaz again, timing him as he comes forward. Now he's got him on the ropes where he wants to. Let's see if Diaz shifts his feet again. Vasquez will keep his in place.
Seems like Diaz waits for Vasquez to get him on the ropes, to stay on the ropes, block a little bit of punches, get him tired.
Exactly.
Then he comes back and attacks him.
And he's let Vasquez dictate the head position so he can counter off of that. When Vasquez moves his head to the other shoulder, that's when Diaz will work.
Nice sneaky body shot there by Vasquez inside. Again, we're halfway through the round, and in the first part of the round, you saw Vasquez landing, not hurting Diaz, but when you're landing scoring shots, you are piling up points. Do you ever have that in your head, Danny, where like, hey, am I leading this round? Do I have to do more? How much energy do I need to expend?
I just try to be as consistent as I can be. You know, to me, every round is a championship round, and I go in every round and take every round like it's my last.
Do you know what round it is when you're in the middle of it, or does that go away?
No, I'm aware of the situation every round.
Hard shots by Vasquez, yeah, as he comes inside there. I'm just wondering how much you think about how long you have to go.
Oh, no, I'm never thinking about that. You know, it's a fight. We prepared one round at a time, get the job done.
Diaz landed a real nice body shot underneath. I don't think our viewers would see it. It's up above us. He landed a real nice body shot underneath to sort of froze Vasquez in his tracks. This is where Vasquez does not want to be. The Diaz shifts over again and comes back over. This is where he does not want to be.
Solid Vasquez. Connecting shot there. Left hand straight to Vasquez's head. So now he takes control in the final minutes. Now this is an interesting round to see what the judges have to do with it. Diaz definitely came on strong. Vasquez, a lot of scoring shots. And Diaz again in the final seconds. Uppercut lands as well in the final seconds of the sixth round. Exciting action. Diaz late. We're back after this in Birmingham.
Yes, no problem.
Diaz very motivated. Replacing Luis Collazo on this card. Says this is a great opportunity. Okay. He was preparing for another fight. We asked him about Vasquez. He said, no, this is a good fighter. He's a very good fighter, but it's nothing I haven't seen before. He's fought the top amateurs in the world. Again, a lot of success, but just management problems, promotional problems through the years. So he's only had a number of fights, low number of fights, coming into this one. Again, he's 32 years old. He's only 17-1. Very few guys, Danny, come up like you where everything just works right. You know, yeah. It's difficult. You can go through a year or two where things just aren't going your way. You're not getting the fights that you need.
Exactly. Well, he's an Olympic gold medalist, so he has that background. You know, he's more advanced than the average person who would turn pro and would be managed to the top. Like, you know, like Vasquez, this is his first real test. You know, Diaz, his test was against Peterson. He didn't pass it, but he got a lot of experience, and is showing this fight to me.
Yeah, that's a good point. Because early on, well, good winging shot there, and another right hand by Diaz. Catches Vasquez flush. Didn't hurt him, but smacked him on the side of the head.
Vasquez is showing the impression that he's fading a little bit. Now, again, I don't know if he gave up a lot of energy just being around his family and playing games earlier today, but he's having a hard time figuring this out. He's going to the rope, something that we've never seen before. And what Diaz is doing is trying to walk Vasquez over to his right side so he could step in and drop that left. When you notice what Diaz does with his subtle shifts. Right there.
So the jab is working too, Virgil. Diaz just doubled up on it and tapped him with that second jab.
Diaz seems he's starting to impose his will. You know, he's trying to take Vasquez's will away and break his heart and, you know, break his soul, make him not believe in himself right now. So Vasquez has to stay mentally strong in this fight.
Mouthpiece came out on Diaz. So Keith Hughes will get back there. And Diaz lives in the Dominican Republic still. And I believe, as Christine mentioned earlier, bought the house that he was raised in. So he's still in that neighborhood. Good shot there to the body. So he's there still with his people. And this would be a huge win for him here, climbing the ladder and getting into just the thick of those big names in the welterweight division.
Now Vasquez is bleeding out of the nose. It was interesting about the mouthpiece because no punch was landed when Vasquez dropped that mouthpiece. So you have to ask yourself, did he deliberately drop it? Hopefully not, but it went out without a punch. So he's showing indications of fatigue, as I said earlier before, and he hasn't figured out Diaz. He's in a danger zone here in losing this fight.
Diaz seems to be getting stronger. He's like a little bull right now, just
Hopping around. Yeah. Early on, we did not see that. Now he's gaining confidence, gaining steam, landing shots, and taking control as we come to the final seconds of round seven. Interesting fight. 1-0 might go. The O from Sammy Vasquez. Being told to fight through to the end of the round, that does have an effect in the final seconds. Sammy's wife, Del Rey, big supporter of his and helping his life stay on track after his two combat missions in Iraq. He's here with two of his stepdaughters. They have three girls all together. First time for the older girls to be here and watch Sammy fight. Obviously, a lot of trepidation from Del Rey right now watching Sammy take on Felix Diaz, who is picking up steam.
Diaz is doing so many subtle shifts that Vasquez can't pick up on it. So Vasquez is quick on his feet, but he's in or out, whereas Diaz is over and under. And so that throws Vasquez off a little bit and leaves him open for counter shots.
Oh, another right hook by Diaz.
And another thing Diaz is doing well is luring him in and then beating him to the punch by stepping in.
What is he doing holding the pads there for him? Like, he's looking to smack away his first shot and counter.
Well, he's feeling good. He knows he's in control of this fight, so he's feeling good. So he's getting his second win. He feels Vasquez's punches. He knows if they're hurting him or not, and they're not hurting him. So he's getting more and more aggressive. He can come in when he wants to. He can back Vasquez up when he wants to. He's giving him a working over this round so far. Vasquez's mouth is wide open. He's bleeding out of the mouth, bleeding out of the nose, and he's conceding by tapping gloves with Diaz. I don't like the way his mouth looks. The blood looks real thick in his mouth. Could it be a fracture? Could it be? I don't want to alarm anybody.
Good left hand right there.
He's having some difficulties.
Seems like he has a gash in his lip.
Yeah, that mouth is wide open, and that you cannot do that. You get your jaw broken. Yeah, you keep that open.
On the right bottom side of his right lip, it seems like he has a gash. Like, busted open a little bit.
Might be swollen, too, a little bit. Looks on the right side of his mouth. Virgil, Dan, you guys could be onto something here, noticing it, that he's having problems.
Well, you have to ask yourself, is he swallowing blood? Now you got Diaz really picking up his speed and activity. We could have a stoppage here.
Mouthpiece goes out again as Diaz marches in and now lets it fly.
I don't know if Vasquez can keep Diaz off of him anymore. You could see the look in his face.
Yeah, mouthpiece came out again. And there it is. It looks swollen. Virgil, you're right. There's a lot of blood in his mouth as well.
He cannot bite down on the mouthpiece.
This is what makes you a true champion. This is what makes you people think you're ready for a world title fight, when you can come back, from taking a beating like this. If Vasquez is ready for a world title fight and ready to be there with the elite, he has to turn this fight around and show that he can face adversity and beat it.
Diaz just snuck an uppercut right up onto Vasquez's chin, which is not good if Vasquez. Oh, my goodness. Nice right hook by Diaz.
Charles Leverick there in the corner. Now, they're not saying anything about an injury or, hey, are you okay? What's the matter? So maybe he just got popped and it's swollen. I don't know.
No, it's a big gash on the top of his lip. If you see this, it's cut open. That's a big gash. So it's probably that's why his mouthpiece probably keeps coming out, because it feels uncomfortable. It probably feels worse than what it is. But it is a big gash on the top of his lip.
He probably doesn't have the ability to bite all the way down on it now, Danny. And Vasquez's eyes is showing that he doesn't quite know what to do with this situation. His eyes are spacey. He's fighting, to me, on memory and instinct. And I really believe if Diaz presses this issue, he could get Vasquez out of here.
There was that moment in the eighth round before Virgil where it looked like there was a possibility. Keith Hughes took a closer look as Diaz started to throw some real bombs there on the ropes and was landing a lot of those shots. But Vasquez, you have to admire his toughness. Mm-hmm. You're right, a lot of this is just going on his memory and on his training and on his toughness and him staying in there.
Well, if you look at his last two jabs, they're tentative jabs where he wants to hit him, but he doesn't want to get hit in this situation either. So he's being real tentative with his jab, and that's not the way to be for a fighter who's behind in the fight. He simply has to let it go if wants to win this fight.
He's taking some good shots, but he hasn't been knocked down or, out on his feet yet. So I wouldn't consider stopping the fight. Mm-hmm. He's still in it. He's won a lot of the earlier rounds. If he can close these last two rounds, he knows he still might have a chance.
Diaz goes to work.
Oh.
Nice firing back by Vasquez. Trapped in the corner, but he fires back. And now Vasquez says, let's do it.
Diaz shows his pedigree by bringing him back over here to the other side. Lured him in. Vasquez showing the heart of a champion. But Diaz showing his pedigree, showing his way around the ring, that he knows this ring. He made Vasquez walk all the way to the other side, tired and hit. Watch him make him come to him again. He's bringing him to him, and then he brings him right to the punch. And Vasquez using a lot of energy right to the punch he comes.
Ryan just jumps right back in with a quick jab.
That's what's going on right now, this dance. I leave, you come. Here we go again, same thing.
Good overhand left by Diaz. Yeah, Diaz, a good overhand left, landing. Vasquez knows he's got to land himself if he's got to win a round. Nice scoring jab as well by Diaz.
For our viewers, this is what you call pedigree. He's walking from corner to corner, each side of the ring, taking a lot of energy out of him, and then runs him into a punch. And each time he walks again, he's a little weaker.
Vasquez just landed a good body shot right there.
And his hands are down. Look at Vasquez's hands.
That's where Vasquez has to let his hands go, right there.
Diaz moving his head nicely and getting out of trouble.
Vasquez is falling. He needs to stay alert, Vasquez does.
A lot of fight in both men as they touch gloves here in Birmingham. Good welterweight scrap. Marcos Villegas through nine as they get to the final round has Diaz ahead 87-84. And that's even giving Vasquez some of those early rounds. I believe the first three rounds to Sammy Vasquez.
Sammy needs to let his combinations go without having bad intentions on it and simply win the round if he's going to have a chance to be in this fight for a victory, either a draw. If he goes for a knockout, he can leave himself open.
Well, what do you tell a guy then, Virgil, if he's behind and that's his only shot?
Well, yeah, he has to do it that way. He has to keep touching and hope that he sneaks something in. But so far, he's tried the last two or three rounds, and he's gotten the worst of it. Right there, he's doing quite well. But is Diaz laying a trap? Is he playing possum? Diaz feels like he has this fight, so he can afford to kind of coast and let Vasquez work hard in the early part of the round, and then he closes the show.
Felix Diaz, a replacement for Luis Collazo, making the most of his opportunity, looking to hang a loss, the first professional loss on Sammy Vasquez. Boy, Keith Hughes is tough. It's like, hey, Keith, they're trying, man. It's the 10th round. Keith's done an excellent job, I have to say.
He has, particularly in a fight of this magnitude and this type of fight.
Hey, Virgil, I appreciate you down now. I think he's saying with the head.
Vasquez cut right there with that overhand left.
Now he's
right
cut
on the top.
I don't know if he was complaining about, was it head-to-head or was it glove-to-head? I'm not sure. But I was going to say, Virgil, you pointed out nicely just the subtleties of all the little things that Felix Diaz is doing. Now Keith Hughes calls time, and I think he wants to take a look at Vasquez. Let's see if that was a headbutt.
I believe it was that overhand left.
No.
Oh, no.
Yeah.
It's collision
of Felix. All right, so he was complaining about the headbutt and then a shot to the back of the head. That's an illegal shot. I don't think Diaz was trying to do that, but when his head went back, that's where it landed. Now sprayed with blood. Sammy Vasquez bothered by this, but again, what he's been through in his life, this is not going to stop him. Might not be enough to win rounds and win this fight, but the toughness is just built into this guy.
Oh, it's evident. Any trainer in the world would love to have the competitiveness in the heart of Sammy Vasquez. Nice left hand Vasquez lands.
Vasquez let that go, but Diaz fires back. Great action here in the 10th round.
Vasquez is just landing some good shots right there. He has to step on it again.
Diaz
let his
is
hands
playing
rip.
Possum. See? He's playing possum, and he cracks Vasquez. Knocks
he's
the
take a point
out.
I think he's going to take a point from him. He said last time, if he does it again, he'll take a point.
Pop that mouthpiece right out. They put it back in the final 20 seconds.
Diaz played possum on.
Yeah, so Keith Hughes is taking a point away, even though a punch took that mouthpiece right out. You agree with that?
You have to, because the ref gave him the warnings. A lot of times, you have to have that custom mouthpiece so you can get ready for those type of situations. We don't know what he has, the type of mouthpiece that he has, if it's custom, if it's fitted well. Usually they're so tight.
Well, it might not matter. That point might put it away, but likely Diaz has spread things out in the final rounds. Good action fight between Vasquez and Diaz. We'll have the decision when we return here live on Fox. Our punch stats are sponsored by Motel 6. We'll leave the light on for you. And look at this. I wouldn't have expected that. So close, thrown, landed, virtually the same between Felix Diaz and Sammy Vasquez. Diaz fighting a beautiful fight late. Vasquez had a point taken away late as well. Let's go to Ray Flores and get the decision. All right, so there was a point taken away in the 10th round by Keith Hughes, the referee. Did the judges not calculate? Because it seems like one point just came off the books. Did they not calculate that one point?
Well, it could not have. But what was disturbing is that if they hadn't have taken that point, Vasquez would have won the fight. But I would like to say, Brian, that I commend the commission of the state of Alabama, and I hope it sets a precedent for all the other commissions. When you see something that dictates right before your eyes what is true, that some of the other commissions in other states will follow suit. It was a great call. I commend the state of Alabama.
Well, they've got to try to get it right. And now as they get it right, Sammy Vasquez does get the first loss of his professional career. Got to be tough for him, but exhilarating for Felix Diaz as he does earn a victory the second time around. Back after this in Birmingham.